Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Pokémon Platinum Wedlocke. I'm Akablay11, and here I am, recording in the morning, despite what I said in the last episode where I'll never record in the morning. I don't know why the heck I said that, because I'd like to start this episode off, if you guys don't mind, with talking about my life a little bit. Because the main reason is, if it wasn't very, very obvious, the schedule that I normally used to have has not come back yet. Despite what I said in... Oh, battle items aren't on because of my training. That's alright, I don't care. I did training, everyone 27. Rhea and Aphrodite evolved. Pretty self-explanatory. There's really not much to say about them. They're pretty standard for what they are. Oh no, we're paralyzed. It's an electric type. It's wonderful. Alright. So, why has my schedule not resumed? I said, it was episode 6, I believe, was the one where, I could have died there if I got paralyzed a couple more times, or if I, you know, couldn't move a couple more times. That wouldn't have been fun. But yeah, after episode 6, there was that long break. As I explained in episode, like, halfway in episode 7, because I recorded the first bit of that during the time of episode 6, and you know. That was my phone. Alright, we're sorry, things. Alright, we're going back to the thing to heal. And since I'm just talking a lot, this first part of this episode, if not most of this episode, is going to be me talking about things in my life. So if that's not interesting to you, I apologize. But if you don't know this stuff, you're going to be questioning why my videos might not be regular. If they ever been regular. Have they ever been regular? I don't know. They've tried to be. I've tried lots of times to make them regular. But I don't think they've ever succeeded. Anyway, battle animations! Okay. On. Thank you. Okay. So, the reason for that month and a half break or so after episode 6 is because my wife and I were living with our in-laws, her parents. Because we moved. The reason we moved from our old house in Minnesota into this new place. Well, I have repels. Let me get that item because I don't want to see anything in this grass because I'm gonna get spiritual on this route. Or at least I'm gonna try to. I don't even know how it works, but we're gonna try. I've got some sewer repels because I was going back and forth through some routes off screen for training because I had to run around a lot to evolve Aphrodite. We now live in Wisconsin, because, like I said, we want to be closer to family, and, closer to family and lower cost of living. I think that's pretty obvious, pretty good reasons to do that. Okay, so why do we want to be closer to family, is one thing. Well, if you didn't know, if you don't pay attention to every single word I've ever said, I have a son now. He is about 6 months, give or take. So we'd like to be close to family for convenience, and so they actually can see him often, because, Minnesota's quite a farther away than the town in Wisconsin that we're living, where her parents live, and, Chicago, where my parents live, because that's where I grew up. Wow, that was the most pointless battle I've ever done. Anyway. See, that's why we moved. We were living there for a month and a half, that's why I didn't have videos, because I didn't feel comfortable recording in a house with the people that I don't... that things, and the internet connection was almost non-existent. I'm dead serious. The internet connection was almost non-existent. It was so bad. Am I gonna get a double battle? I just ran into two people's lines of sight. Okay, no, I didn't. The jogger didn't see me yet. He'll probably see me immediately after this battle, but oh, that's alright. Okay. Anyway. Wow, how many times have I interrupted this train of thought I've had? Too many. Yeah. After that month and a half ended, we moved into our new house where I could record again, and that's how I ended up resuming videos with, like, episode 7 and whatnot. So, new house! I love our new house. I absolutely love our new house. I'm not gonna lie. That's a good thing. Here's the other thing. You know, this might sound weird, but when you move, you can't keep the same job. You have to get a different job. So, how do you get jobs? Well, you apply to them. I applied to, like, tons, like 50 plus jobs that I have applied to that I qualify for, because I qualify for, technically, I feel like I qualify for a lot, I have a degree in business, and I've worked in different types of management and number crunching related office positions for several years. Several years combined, I would say. So I feel like I'd be qualified for a lot of different jobs. Well, after the millions of jobs I applied for, literally one got back to me. Two. I interviewed at two, one gave an offer, the other didn't. So I took the only offer I got. And the job itself, it's not horrible. The job itself is not horrible. I could deal with it if it wasn't for one thing. The hours. What hours does this job is this job? Well, up until this point, it has been 2:30 in the afternoon to midnight. It is purely a second shift, as they call it, position. In theory, there's nothing wrong with that. In essence, there's really nothing wrong with that. So, why is there something wrong with that? Well, my wife works 8 to 5, like a normal person, like most people work. So I never see her. I never see her. I'm at home by myself during the day. She's at work. I leave before she gets home. I work all afternoon and evening. And when I get home at past midnight, she's asleep. And then we wake up and do it again. So we really only see each other on weekends. And what about my son? Well, the reason I don't see him is because he's at a daycare during the day. Why don't I just watch him during the day and she watch him in the afternoon so I actually see him? Well, do you want me to sleep from only 1 p.m. to 5 a.m.? That's one reason. And also, we don't, our shifts overlap. I began, like I said, at 2:30. She gets home at 5. So he's have to be watched by someone for a short period of time. And her family's not available to do that. It'd be great if they were, but no, they have their own lives and work that they have to do. So I'm by myself during the day. In theory, oh, that jogger didn't even see me. In theory, that would be amazing for videos, right? Absolutely zero interruptions during the whole day. All day to myself to record and upload and do my own thing. Well, in theory is the key word. It sounds amazing, but here's another strange thing that may come to a shock. Videos are not the priority in my life. My family is. They are, without a doubt, the priority in my life. And just with these... how long has it been with I've had this job? I don't even remember. Maybe a month or two? Maybe a month and a half. Or 2 months. Month and a half, 2 months, something like that I've had this job. I've already missed so much. With my son, especially. Do you guys know how fast babies grow? I didn't know how fast babies grow. I've never had one before. My God, they grow fast. I've missed so much already. It's already, like, kind of making me really upset that I'm missing so much of his life. I know it doesn't sound like much, but he's so different than he was when I was actually saw him all the time. So, instead of spending my time with... making videos like I could be. I've been spending that time looking for other jobs. I don't know how else to say that. Do you guys know finding a job is not easy. Finding a job is not easy. That's not true. Finding available jobs is actually probably one of the easiest things in the world. I kind of get upset when someone says there's no jobs anywhere. I can't find work anywhere. Are you looking under a rock or what? There are literally jobs absolutely everywhere. Go to your local retail store. I guarantee you they'll have an opening somewhere. But you might not want to do that. Because, well, I have to make a certain amount of money to support my family, so I can't just take the first thing I find. For example, I applied to a job at, I'm not gonna lie, Walmart. The shift hours would be perfect, but they do not pay enough. At least at the entry level position, because why would they? Why would they pay a lot of money for something that, you know, that someone that they can get someone who isn't as qualified as me. Let's put it that way. They could easily get someone who is not as qualified as me and do the exact job. And why would they need to pay me more? Yeah. And that's just one example. There's a lot of jobs I've applied to that either never got back to me, don't think I'm qualified, or they don't pay enough. So it has not been easy. That's what I've been spending my time doing. Here's another thing. Just I thought I'd throw this out there. The place we live in now is a much, much smaller area than where I lived in Minnesota. Minnesota, we lived in the outskirts of Minneapolis. It's a pretty decently sized city, with lots of jobs in all parts of the town. Now we live in a fairly, for lack of better words, rural area, where it's really not that big of a town. And you know what kind of jobs are out here mostly? Manufacturing. And there's nothing wrong with that type of work. I would be glad to do it. But they all require experience. I want to get... This is a small rant, kind of, that I'm about to go into, but... college guys? I'm going to tell you right now, it's almost completely pointless. Unless you are going for a very, very specific degree that gets you one very specific job. For example, my wife. She went to school to be a physical therapist. That you need to go to school for. You need to get a doctorate in that. Doctorate in physical therapy. You need to get that to get to do that job. But that's the only job you qualify for after that. So if you're going to college for a job like that, yeah, that matters. If for me, getting a degree in business... Not gonna lie, it's almost completely pointless. Because despite a four-year Bachelor of Science degree in business administration with three or four years of management and experience and like about 2 years of number-crunching office work, not a single bit of that helps me with the jobs out here. All I want, guys, is experience in their specific field. How do you get experience? How would you ever get hired in a position like that if they require experience? How do you get experience if they never hire you because you don't have any experience? Oh, it's easy. You gotta have connections. You don't fight me, Barry. I'm not worried. You gotta have connections. You gotta know someone. I don't know anybody here. You basically, apparently, when you're in high school in this town, if you know somebody, you can get unpaid internships there, which sound like the dumbest thing you could possibly do. But no, you do that for 6 months? Wow, you have 6 months experience in that field. That's enough to get you a job. It might not be the job you want, but it's, in theory, if it is what you're going for, there's absolutely no reason to get a degree in anything. I apologize for that rant there, but I'm just trying to get out the point that I've not been successful with my looking for jobs. The one I have now that has the shift that I don't like, I got it because it's purely management. I don't really want to get into the details of what it is, but my title is district supervisor. I feel like that's a pretty nice title to have on your resume, but, it's not getting me anything. I guess I haven't done it for very long, but at the same time... Oh boy, I'm looking for a job with normal hours so I could see my family. Is that so much to ask? That's the bottom line to it, guys, and that it's hard to find it because of this small town, there's hardly any opportunities here for what I specifically qualify for or for what would pay enough to support my whole family. So that's the position I'm in. That's why my schedule right now is weird. If you even say what I have as a schedule. It's not, I don't even have a schedule. It's just kind of videos. Like I just kind of post videos. There's not really a schedule or rhyme or reason to it. I just kind of do what I can when I can. Like I am right now. I decided to take today and be like, screw looking for jobs, because I'm not finding any luck. I would just like to have some fun playing Pokemon, and I just found a frickin' encounter. I guess I'm getting a Roselia, not a Spiritomb. Okay. That's my fault, guys. I apologize. But at the same time, I like Roselia, so I don't really mind. I already have a Budu, but... Oh, well, this will actually have Leech Seed. I think it will actually have Leech Seed. I think. Well, that was dumb. That's what happens when I'm talking about things. When playing a game, I'm being distracted. But the things I had to say were important. So now that you know... Okay. Oh, what about streams? What about live streams? Well, I technically could live stream, but, is anybody out there gonna actually be available midday during the weekday? Like, 11 a.m. to or noon or something like that? Would anybody actually be available during that time to see the streams? I'm sure some people would, but I'd like to think most people have school or a job to be at during that time. I like to think. I don't think anyone would be there for this for streams, so I... Wow, this person thinks Leech Seed always wins. They're right, but you only need to use it once. Nest Ball, why not? I don't know if it'd be any good, but it's green. That's all I gotta say for that matter. Let's get back into Pokemon, I guess. I guess if I ever do get a job that has normal hours, will my schedule ever come back? Good question. I don't know. All right, this is Dionysus, or Dionysus. I've heard it pronounced both ways. I don't know how it is, but he is the god of wine. I'm sure he's other things too, but wine is grown from grapes. Grapes are plants, or the fruit from plants. Roselia is a plant. So there you go. That's how I got that name. Will my schedule return? By schedule, I mean videos on the main channel every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Videos on Blue Gator Gaming every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. And streams in the evening every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And often Saturday as well. Will my schedule return as normal if I get a normal shift? My answer to that is... maybe. Just maybe. Why just maybe? Hold on, I want to see what's on this route. Alright guys, on 210, there's actually two sections of it. There's the south section, which is the section we're in right now, and there's the north section, which is foggy right now, that we need defogged way later in the game. I'm not gonna catch anything here right now. I'm gonna wait till we get that, so I'm gonna use repels throughout these grass, you know, assuming I think of it, instead of just screw up like I did the last route and not get Spiritomb. That's alright. But anyway, there's also another area down here I need to get. This little tower. It's probably just going to be a Zubat. But hey, Zubats have never failed me before. So, wow. Two steps and I find something. It is not a Zubat, it's a Ghastly! Ooh! Although I might actually kill it. Because it's kind of low level. Do I have any Quick Balls? Why don't I have any Quick Balls? Alright, well, yeah, we only have... I think my weakest thing is Water Gun or Aqua Jet. Let me look at my stuff. Attack and Special Attack are kind of equal. It's Physical Attack's a little higher. 40. They're both 40 base power! I didn't know that! So actually, I think Water Gun's weaker. Because I have slightly less Special Attack. Oh, boy. You know what? It might use Curse. Let's just throw a Great Ball. Let's throw a Great Ball. It might use Curse to try to kill itself. So we're just gonna throw Great Balls. Nah. Nah, it appeared to be caught. Nah, Spite. I'll throw a Nest Ball or two as well, because it is decently lower level than me. Oh, this isn't helping. I'm just throwing my money away. Let's throw a Nest Ball. Sorry, I wanna focus on. Oh, this is doing okay. This is doing okay. Yeah, nest ball. Thank you. We got a Ghastly. Aw, yeah. All right, I'm very happy about that. And in case this wasn't made clear at any point during this Nuzlocke, I can get trade evolutions anytime I want. Unless I require a specific item to do said trade evolution, then I need said item. But just like Haunter Gengar, that's fine. So, alright, nickname for Ghastly, hold on. This is Hecate. Pretty sure that's how you pronounce her name, Hecate. Or Hecate, I think, I'm pretty sure it's Hecate. She is the goddess of witchcraft, magic, and like, she apparently has very good knowledge of poison and ghosts. So, perfect. Who should we have up front? No one's grown a level this whole episode. Let's have Aphrodite up front. Let's see if she'll do good. She probably won't, though, because she kind of sucks. Oh, something that kind of made me mad. I wanted to, evolve her before level 13 to allow Punny so she'd get Return, not Frustration, because obviously Return is better, especially when you evolve by Happiness. I didn't, because I thought she... I didn't. She didn't evolve when I thought she would, so all she's got is Quick Attack and Jump Kick. And she's also got a really lame strategy where she could do Defense Curl and Baton Pass. I don't know if I'll ever use it, but hey, it's there. And yeah, we'll give her a try. So, back to what I was trying to say this whole time. Why might my schedule not return when I have a normal shift? That's simple. Because as time goes on, like I said, my son is going to be growing up more and more. And I feel like I'll be wanting to actually spend more time with him instead of spending time doing recordings and videos and stuff. Because the thing is, assuming I do get that normal shift, I will be home at the same time as my wife and son, which runs into the quote-unquote problem I had before, which was finding time to record because I'm either working or with them. Now I have the problem where I'm either working or home by myself. So guys, if I never wanted to see my family, I technically have the perfect schedule for making videos because I have nothing holding me back from making videos except me. Not no work or other people, quote unquote, getting in the way, so to speak. But unfortunately, I do care to see my family. And it really also sucks that this chat just put me to sleep. But that's alright, we'll get through it. So that's my story right now. I'm looking for other jobs because I want to see them. So I'm still making these, as you can clearly see by this video you're watching right now. Oh, and by the time you're watching this, probably I may have to be starting working at 1 p.m. through midnight. As opposed to 2:30, because, you know, as district supervisor, there's a lot expected out of you, apparently, and... Apparently I have to work, when someone is not, someone doesn't work anymore, meaning they leave the job, I'm responsible for covering all of their work until they hire someone new, so... As far as I'm aware, I've been working from 1 to midnight every single day until either they hire someone or I get a different job. For the record, though, I have the week I'm recording this, I have interviews scheduled this week for more jobs. I've had a couple interviews for more jobs, but like I've said, they've either led to nothing or the job they offer doesn't pay enough. And yeah, I have to make a certain amount of money. I'm making plenty of money with the current job I have. So, well, I have calcium. It'd be silly to just give up that job for a lower paying job as fast as I can. It's more than just lower paying. You know, if we could make it work, we'd make it work in a heartbeat because that's how much, that's how much I'd like to have a different job and how much I'd like to see my family. If a lower pay could work, we would do it in a heartbeat. But the pays I've been offered so far have not cut it. So I unfortunately have to keep looking, and I will keep looking. And there's fog up here. I forgot that up here is foggy. Is that gonna be a problem? Is there anything up here? In Diamond and Pearl, like, you get HM Strength up here, but you don't get that in Platinum up here. I'm pretty sure you just get, like, a cleanse tag or something. Oh, well, we got our Pokemon that was in here. That's really all I cared about. The other up there is just pointless trainers. And yeah, I'm 210. I gotta remember to have repels up because I don't want to catch anything in the southern part of the grass. There's better things in the northern part, which I can't access yet. And here's a cut tree, but no one knows cut because Psych died. Just so I know, who can learn cut? Apparently I can't push up. And I bet some of you are thinking, hey, you have the TM for return. Why not just teach return to Aphrodite? Well, because Aphrodite's a freaking Lopunny. Oh, but you can learn cut. I'll consider it, but so far, no, I don't want anyone who can to learn it. That item can't be that good, can it? Yeah, I don't want to teach her it because she's a Lopunny, and Lopunnies are not amazing. And hey, here's the daycare. I have no rule against, using the daycare in this game, but that's because I don't have, there's no healing points, so there's really no reason to limit how I can train. So I can use the daycare to train if I want, but will I? Probably not, because I won't get any EVs. Not that I need any, or that anyone actually pays attention to EVs in Nuzlocke, but you never know. I'm gonna fight you, because why not? I thought I would tough it up while working on the ranch. I'm proud of them. Yeah. Okay. Rancher Marco with a Ponyta, and I've got an Aphrodite. Okay, would jumping or quick attack be stronger? Who knows? Let's try both. And also because I've been recording very infrequently, I think I'm losing my touch. If I even had a touch to begin with. I think that's up for debate as well. If I even had a touch to begin with. They do about the same damage, so there's no point in using jump kick because it can miss, and if it misses, it hurts you. So... And it doesn't always go first. So unless jump kick's super effective, use quick attack. So in other words, it'd be really great if I had return or a better normal move. But I don't. Let's fight one more trainer. We'll be done for today, I think. I know we hardly did anything, but this was a let's have a real talk episode, not a let's make progress episode. Dugger Wyatt with a Pikachu. That's not good. Because Minius can't fight that. And Minius is, you know, the good one of this pair. And Aphrodite will probably get paralyzed from Static. Or from Thunder Wave. Take your pick. That works. Alright, just quick attack though and don't be paralyzed and we win. Yay, good job, Aphrodite. Good job. I'm actually surprised. So in that case, I'm impressed. And we did not grow a level. Nope, we didn't grow a single level this whole episode. That means less editing for me, so that's alright. Let's get those berries, then we'll be done. We still have a repel up, right? Yes, we definitely do. Okay. So, yeah. Job hunting, guys. It really sucks. My pro tip, for those of you who are still in school, or... more so if you're not in college yet, because if you are in college, it's already too late for you, because you're already there, you're stuck there, you've already paid some money to be there. But if you're there, I hope you're going for something that's actually going to help you, I truly do. I'm not going to lie, my degree helped me get my last job, the last job I had, back in, you know, a metropolitan city. I don't live in a metropolitan city, though, right now, so it does nothing out here. It does nothing. Metropolitan is the right word, right? I think it is. Alright, so. But yeah, the tip I was about to say. Really, really think about what it is you can do with your life and what jobs actually are looking for. If there are jobs out there that specifically want a degree before you can get them, go for it. But I guarantee you, even jobs that require a degree, they also require job experience. So, if you are in school right now, and if you've never had a job, I'd start looking for a job. It doesn't have to be a job that you do your whole life. As a matter of fact, it won't be. I guarantee it won't be, because no one has... Okay, that's not true. Most people never have just one job their whole life. They start with something, use that job to get experience, and then get something else. I've had about 5 jobs my whole life, and I haven't lived too long yet, according to most people. So yeah. Try to find a job that will get you some experience in a field. Do that for a decent amount of time, and then that will automatically open new doors for jobs you couldn't get before. And if you're saying, well, I don't have any experience, how do I get jobs? Well, I'm dead serious. Walk to your local retail store, like a Walmart or a Target, or anything. I guarantee you will find something. Absolutely guarantee it. It could be a part-time job. You work just weekends. Even if you work one day a week for a year, that's still a year's experience. Pro tip from Aquablade 11. Thank you for watching today's episode. I hope you enjoyed. Hope to look forward to the future. Hopefully my schedule will return someday, but I can't make any promises because my family comes first. So as much as I enjoy doing this, for that month and a half I had off, I realized that if I didn't do YouTube, I'd be okay. So, I still love doing it, though. So, I'm going to do it as long as I still love it. So, hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Thank you, and rock on.